Mr. Chopra. Tell us about this occasion. Why this is on the 60th birthday of Mrs. Anjolie Ela Menon.
Well, you see, the 60th birthday is a very important thing in India, as you know. And as it is the birthday of an artist who has a lot of friends, is a 60th birthday. And you know that a 60th birthday is an important thing in India. And as a birthday, there is a certain informality of friendliness, a coming together. So we're all very relaxed here. And as such, the kind of work that you get is equally relaxed. It's much more natural. It's something that is made with a friend in mind. Of course, there are some works like Naina Kanodia's, which in fact reflect the birthday. There are other works which reflect ongoing life and its beauty. So in that sense, it's something that allows people to come together without feeling that it's something that is contrived, like a camp where people produce work, hand it over, live in a hotel for a few days, and they feel they've paid.
Tell us something about what Anjolie Ela Menon is to you as a person and as an artist.
You see, Anjolie Ela Menon is a friend, and as a friend, you naturally feel for everything that happens in their lives and in the ongoing process of life. And we also have many common friends going over the years. So it's a part of a process for me. And it's a process that has come to a successful point. And we hope that from this point on, there'll be yet newer heights to scale. So it's a feeling of progress, a feeling of getting on, a feeling of going on, and a feeling of life becoming more interesting and different as we go on.
What exactly is she? What sort of person you feel she is? What a personality.
She is a very liberal person, which in our day is something very important. As you know, we are living in very difficult times. There is a man like Balbir Kutt, who has just disappeared 5 months ago. He's a leading sculptor, the head of the department of BHU, of art. And, you know, he's just disappeared. And nobody knows where he is. Now, at times like these, you need people who are broad-minded, who are sensible, who can understand the other person's point of view. And you can see that in her work. Her work is not parochial. Her work is very universal. It has elements that are concretely rooted in India. It has elements of the Byzantine. It has elements of universal and even distant art. So at times like these, you need people who can look beyond themselves and see the other person's point of view as well.
How will you define her as an artist or her work? How will you define her work?
I would say that her work is very lyrical, and it is also modern. It has an element of the same kind of ambiance as Amrita Shergill, who impressed her a great deal. But I mean, she has her own expression, which is very different. And her art, in my view, is modern Indian art, and as such, very relevant to our lives today.